Under the theme Paving the Way for Post-COVID-19 Recovery and the Full Realization of the 2030 Agenda, Empowering Youth Participation, the event drew distinguished figures from various corners of the country. President Yoweri Museveni implored the youth to adopt discipline as their guiding principle, shielding themselves from the allure of youthful indiscretions.
Kirumu, obukum to ine man, enkwesi to ine man. Mbwenu, okukushemi ra, okubu yayo, Tarum Kibaro Kuru Gunsiza, Wayetuara, Reduction of Washing Yanku, is Hamile, is in Norkara. So the first thing is to resist the temptations of youth. But those are really no value addition, they will add nothing to you.
The president encouraged them to wholeheartedly embrace education, ensuring they acquire qualifications that align seamlessly with the demands of the modern world.
Secondly, studies. Concentrating on your studies. So that you get knowledge, but you also get qualifications. Now, thirdly, ideology. Part of the problem is that the youth, some of the youth get wrong ideology. Ideology of sectarianism, of religion, of tribes, of working for foreign interests.
At the same event, Chigezi regional leaders hailed the government for fighting towards improving the lives of the youth, but also urged them to solve some of the challenges still existing.
We have a group which is always neglected as the youth, and this is the primary school level. Much as we provide them with education, much as we provide them with some skills, but we should know that in Uganda, at any one time, we have 8 million youth who are in primary schools.
Understood your strategic guidance, and we are moving towards that. In terms of local content, here in the Kabara and Chigezi region, we have embraced the parish development model, a strategic innovation to move our households who are in still subsistence into an economy. I think we can, Your Excellency, Omuri Kabale, million zirika mushanju na millioni gwenda za chianu ya za parish development model.
We are only asking for around one thing. You're training the youth, the presidential skilling hubs, but we are requesting if every district would spare some piece of land, so that we can put there the youth, especially those that have been trained. Because even paying rent from the little money that we give them is a challenge.
Youth leaders also voiced their concerns to the president.
Businesses if you have Omuri Kabale have mashanyarazi. Amashanyarazi gamira mashanyarazi. President wola bagamani twe ogamira muchakwata o eshongaza mashanyarazi bazikolewo. Mwaka Kabale mashanyarazi bakale wali mu mwiki.
It is true that many of the countries that are telling Uganda to not fund the crude oil pipeline are also the very ones who have the highest emission rates globally. For those that do not know, our crude oil pipeline will not emit more in the length of 30 years than countries like France emit in 1 year.
The event also saw the signing of an agreement between the government of Uganda and the Afro-Arab Youth Council that will see various ventures established in Uganda to uplift the youth, according to Agaba Abbas, the Afro-Arab Youth Council Secretary General.
abatona bakuru.
Report by Job Namaya for the news.